Thanos snap effect is one of the best Easter eggs from Google that I really like. But since Google obfuscate their code, it's a little bit hard to see the technique they use. So in the past couple of days, I spent some time trying to create one on my own, and the result is what you have seen. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you and explain how I did it. Let's check it out. First, let's begin with the concept. If you inspect the Google animation, you will see that they create multiple canvases that each one contain part of the original element, then rotate and transform them until they fade away. So with this concept, we will need to find a way to convert our element to image on canvas object. Then randomly distribute pixels from that image to multiple canvases. And finally add animation to each of them. Simply put, convert the element to image, chop them to pieces, and add the animation. Let's start with the first step. Fortunately, we have a very useful library called HTML to Canvas. You can pass any HTML element and it will return Canvas object for you. Since the code of this tutorial is quite long, I'm not going to type but explain it to you step by step instead. Once we have included the library, we'll pass our div element to get the canvas object. Then we'll get an array containing all pixels data from it. Now if you remember, next step is to chop them to pieces. We have the pixels array, we'll try to distribute the pixels data to multiple canvases. But this is a little bit tricky, since we want animation to start fading away from top to bottom. We need majority pixels at the top of burger to be in the first group of canvases, and majority of bottom pixels in the last canvases group. This way, when we start each canvas animation sequentially, it will look like it's fading from top to bottom. The problem is, this is not a regular random anymore. So we can just use method random. What I did was creating a weighted distribution function. Basically, we'll just increase the probability for the top pixels to be in the first canvas's group and the bottom pixels to be in the last. Here is the comparison between regular and weighted distribution of pixels. To achieve this, I also use chance.js, a JavaScript library dedicated for random utilities. We made a tutorial video about this 1 month ago, so check it out if you are interested. Now we have the distributed pixels data, we will create canvases from them and assign a class name, then append them to the wrapper. The last step is to add animation. First, we will start fading away the original content using jQuery fadeout. And then for each canvas, we will add three animations. First is blur. We add this to soften the transform or it will look pixelated. The second is transform. This is to move the pixels away from the original position. We add both rotation and translate using random value to simulate dust effect. And the third is fade out to fade away the dust particles. The tricky part is jQuery doesn't directly support blur or transform animation, so I have to manually create a function for them. I also add a small delay between canvases to create top to bottom fading animation. On the CSS side, there's nothing much. Just flex display to center everything and basic style for snap button. The only thing related to the effect is position absolute here. This is to make all the canvases stay on the same position. The rest of the animation are handled by the JavaScript. So that's how it works. It took me several hours to get them right. I know it's a lot of take in and quite complicated, so let me know if you have any questions or feedback. I will post the source code on our website. Please find the link at the description box below. And that's all for this video. Hope you guys enjoy, and don't forget to like or subscribe if you are new to this channel. Stay tuned for next video and see you next time. Bye.